My name's Dave Wiegers. I'm from Gurnee, Illinois. I grew up in Southern Illinois, grew up around Lincoln. And I'm here today to take pictures for the university. We're documenting Lincoln Hall here on the quad. I am an amateur photographer. I've been a photographer ever since I was in high school. I became interested in Lincoln statues a few years ago because I ran into a couple that I just wasn't familiar with, and they kind of piqued my interest, and I couldn't find any information about them. And one thing led to another, and here we are 4 years later, and we've visited between 200 and 210 different statues, 35 different states, 40,000 miles of driving or flying, and they're still building them. And so every time I think I'm done, they pull me back in, and I end up running off to some place to take a new picture. Lincoln was such a monumental figure, pardon the pun, I guess, but and even while he was alive, people were already doing busts. It was not more than a couple years until there was a statue erected of Lincoln in, of all places, the first one was in San Francisco. And the people in San Francisco wanted to honor Lincoln. The statues themselves, though, and why I found them so interesting is they're so diverse. You've got Lincoln the Great Emancipator, which was kind of the early tack that sculptors took. Then after that, he was the statesman. Probably the most well-known and the one that really started that movement was the one in Chicago in Lincoln Park, the Augustus St. Gaudens Lincoln, the man, where he's standing like this with his hand on his coat. And then recently, it's been more of commemorating Lincoln as a person. They've kind of literally brought Lincoln down off the pedestal. And a lot of the ones, the sculptor invites the public up to be right next to Lincoln. Illinois has by far the most statues of Lincoln, as you can imagine. And I, off the top of my head, I couldn't even tell you how many. I know there's probably 40 or more. All the way from up in my area in Lake County, there's a couple. All the way down to Jonesboro, which is one of the site of one of the Lincoln-Douglas debates. And that was just put up recently. It was the last debate site that did not have a statue. They had a big rock with a plaque. Some of the more unusual places that we've been, Honolulu, believe it or not, there's a wonderful statue of Lincoln out there by the same artist that has the fairly well-known statue in New Salem, a guy named Avard Fairbanks. There's a number of them up in the Northwest. There's a lot in California, believe it or not. In Burbank, of all places, there's a statue of Lincoln on a corner in a park. There's a whole group of statues strung out along U.S. Highway 30, Lincoln Highway, that were made by a company in Salem, Ohio, called the Mullins Company. And they weren't poured bronze like most statues. They are pounded and pressed like the Statue of Liberty. Today what we're doing, we've got a 90-foot crane, and they're lifting me up pretty much to eye level of all of the terracotta work here in the building, and we're taking overall shots of each one of the items on the building. Lincoln Hall, the way this is laid out is as you move around on the north side, there are a number of panels, and each, within those panels there's a quotation from Abraham Lincoln. And as you move around here to the quad side, there are 10 panels that move through Lincoln's life, starting when he got to Illinois at 21, and it shows him out in the woods, cutting down trees, splitting logs, whatever. Then as you move through, it moves through him as he gets a little older. He took a raft trip. He was a circuit lawyer. It shows him debating Stephen Douglas. Eventually then moves from 1809, when he was born, to 1860, 61. And then the second half of the building, there's another five frames on the north side of this that have more to do with him as president. The first inaugural, Gettysburg Address, reviewing the troops, and then the front of the building is quite nice. It's rather ornate. You have these two beautiful eagles up there in Lincoln Hall. And then even on the inside of the building, as you go inside, there's an entry hall, and there's a bust of Lincoln. If you ever go in the building, notice that Lincoln's nose is worn. Apparently students rub his nose on their way to class. It's good luck. I don't know if it helps them pass anything, but it's a tradition apparently. I read so much about Lincoln. I just respect him so much for where he came from and where he ended up. I just wonder what would have been if he hadn't been assassinated. What changes would we have seen in the United States after the Civil War in that Reconstruction period that would have been different than what we went through? He's somebody that I think we can all learn something from. It comes back down to this concept of American memory, and memory of, in general, of why we erect monuments and why we have statues. It gets into the human psyche. We want to have something that we can see and touch to help us remember the person that it honors. They're not idols and they're not icons. They're just there to help spark something in us.